we have in Ghana right now made enormous investments in our industrial base. In the last, we normally spent about 4 to 5% on capital as a company. Here we spent 30%. We build new warehouses, we build production facilities for tea, for laundry. We really are setting ourselves up for Ghana today, but also we think and invest for Ghana tomorrow. So we've invested about 30 million euros just in the last 2 or 3 years alone. That you can only justify if you have this longer term vision. And we tell the guys here, and they're doing an outstanding job, keep going, because the potential is there and we need to unlock the country together. The same thing on the value chain. We obviously are big partners of people like Olam or Barry Callebaut on the cocoa, and we work with them extensively to be sure that the value chains are sustainable. And that is very important to us and increasingly to the consumers of our products. Here with TOPS, we have a great opportunity. Huh? TOPS itself is about 3,000 acres, and then you have the smallholder farmers, about 1,200 acres around there, and employs currently about 3,000 jobs. I've always felt that we need to do two things. We need to make it more sustainable and set the standards for Africa. We think you can increase the yield and productivity by 3 or 4 times. I just came last week from Indonesia, and I signed with President Jagowi agreements on palm oil, where we are starting to employ 35,000 people and doing this very sustainably. Here we would like to invest in mill, putting a mill in there, and ensuring that it's all source certified, sustainable palm oil. The employment would probably go in initial phases from 3,000 to about 6,000. Smallholder farmers, but then we set it up properly. We invest in it, we make it sustainable, we increase the yield, we bring the latest agricultural techniques to that. And this all goes towards our commitment of creating these 5 million jobs I was talking to you about. And that's important to us. We think that Ghana should be one of the focus countries for us on acceleration of the implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals, with a special focus on agriculture. So you have a great, in this case, Nigerian running the African Development Bank. He also was your former colleague in terms of Minister of Agriculture. He is very keen on helping explode that. We have Kofi Annan, who is always calling me, what more can we do in Ghana? What more can we do in Ghana? He is probably your biggest ambassador abroad, multiplied by about 100. On top of that, his father grew up in Unilever, so he has Unilever in his blood. And he certainly would be keen also to see if we can scale even beyond that. So what we're doing here with TOPS is very important to me, because it's the first step. We've been able together with your new government, which I appreciate, to do in 4 months what has taken us the last 4 or 5 years, and I really appreciate that. But I also really think it's the best thing for the country. We are ready to invest about 35 million euros more into the plantation and its infrastructure around it to get it up to the best standards globally, and then hopefully even work with you to further expansion. So what we see in TOPS, if we can now conclude this in the next week or two, which really then has to happen, because we're all ready now. You know, we've been waiting so long, you can understand that. If we conclude this in the next week or two, I'm convinced with your support and help, we're up and running. So that's why I wanted to divert my journey and be here to be with you.
There's really a familiarity and a closeness, I think, with Unilever. And I think, you know, as far as we, as a government, are very private sector oriented and want the private sector to really help drive economic growth, we like to see companies like Unilever do well in our economies, because when you do well, it means you're creating jobs, you're paying taxes, and you're satisfying consumers. And for us, those are very, very important things. And as you said, I mean, looking everything at the long term, you're not in and out for a quick buck and you disappear. You're here and you've stood the test of time. So I think on behalf of the president, who has had to visit Zambia and therefore could not be here. I'm sure he'd have been happy to see you again after Brussels. So on behalf of the president, I want to thank you very much personally for the commitment that you have to the SDGs as a whole, and to Unilever in Ghana in particular. And essentially, we want to move away from a basic raw material producing and exporting country to a country that adds value, that is manufacturing. Because if you look at the value chain, that is where you ought to be. The value is created when you actually manufacture and add value to the products, the raw materials that you produce here. And so the whole vision is to create an economy that is able to deliver that transformation. The Minister for Agriculture has launched Planting for Food and Jobs program. and AGRIC is really key for Nana Akufo-Addo's strategy for economic transformation. And I think we want to see much more improved yields and apply a little bit more science, you know, with seeds, with fertilizers and so on. In agriculture, make sure that irrigation facilities are available. We have this One Village, One Dam program, which is geared towards making water available. Fertilizers are also going to be cheaper and available and so on. So AGRIC is a major, major pillar for our economic transformation. And I think the top issue that you are very interested in falls very much within what we want to see happen in AGRIC, and I think that should be quite good for us to see, even in the context of our international relations. We're saying, you know, come in and let's work in partnerships, you know, with the government so that we can have access to your resources, but we don't have to borrow it. You know, so that is the thinking that we are taking towards our development and our economic transformation. So you're most welcome.